Wouldn't it be great if you could use Trello as a complete CRM system? Wouldn't it be great if you could open up any Trello card and add customer information right here within the card, but then be able to access this and reuse it in other cards or other boards? And wouldn't it be fantastic if you could get some meaningful data out of your Trello board so that you can follow each and every one of your leads through the sales process? Well, the good news is you can. And in this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about how to use Crmble for Trello so you can get the most out of your CRM system. So in order to get started with Crmble, all you need to do is either create a new Trello board or you can select an existing board. Maybe you already have a pipeline or a sales funnel board right here within Trello. For that particular board, go up to Show Menu, then select the Power Ups option. And in the search bar, all we need to do is search for CRM, and the very first selection is Crmble. Just like you would for any other Trello Power Up, all we need to do is select Add, and now we can start using these features right here within this board. Now, once you've enabled Crmble for your Trello board, you'll be presented with the Crmble interface. And what I love about this is that it doesn't open it up in a separate tab. You can manage this directly here within Trello. Now, you can either use your existing list for that particular Trello board, or you can select from a collection of templates which Crmble provides. So in this case, I'm going to use this six-step process, starting with new leads and contacts, all the way to first call, and hopefully to get them to this closed status. And of course, you can make any changes that you want, either here in the Crmble list tab or on your Trello board. So maybe instead of first call, I want to rename this. I'm going to call this one follow up. Follow up is what this one is going to be. I'm going to say update, and then that's going to be reflected on my Trello board as well. The next place that you're going to want to visit is the Crmble Fields tab, because this is going to show us all of the contact information, but also the lead information that we want listed on each card. Now, when first starting out, Crmble's going to give you a number of options, and a lot of these are fantastic. Things such as name and contact information, job title, maybe things like address, and even an additional notes field so that the notes stay with that client, stay with that prospective lead, and don't just get lost in a Trello card somewhere down the line. Down below, we have lead information. So if you want to keep track of things like your source, when this client was created, and the value of the deal, you can do so as well. Crmble makes it really easy if we want to toggle things on or off. Maybe I don't care about their job title, so I'm going to toggle that particular one off. And just like regular custom fields within Trello, you can choose to display this information on the front of the card as well. Maybe I want the name and surname to be displayed on the front of the card, so I can toggle it here, and maybe I can choose to hide the birthday information on the inside of the card if I don't want to see it. I can still add it to the contact record, I just don't want to be able to see that when I'm within my particular Trello card. Of course, if you want to add your own fields, all you need to do is hit the plus button up here, and you can create your own custom fields, which will be displayed within that client area within the Trello card. Now that we've set up both our lists and our fields, let's close the dialog and return to our Trello board. So here you can see we have the same list, which we just saw within the Crmble field. And even if we renamed it, it's going to reflect it here as well. So let's start in the new leads column. And let's say I've got a big deal worth a lot of money. That's the name of this particular deal, just for this example. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this card, and everything looks pretty regular here. However, right in the middle, just below the description area, is where I have my Crmble field. I can directly input, enter the information of this prospective client. It's going to save it to my Crmble database so I can reuse it as often as I want. So let's go ahead and enter in some information about our prospect. I'm going to say this is Jane Doe. I'm going to say that her number is 555-432-1111. Email address is jdoe@email.com. And maybe just some notes, had a great conversation at the conference, something like that. So I'm going to say save new contact at this point. And what it's going to do, it's going to add it directly here, not only so I can see it, retrieve it, and review it here within my Trello card, but it's also going to save it to my Crmble database. So if I need to repurpose Jane Doe, maybe she's going to purchase something else from me in the future. Maybe I'm going to try and sell her for another product or service. I can do that as well. I've got all this information here. Down below, you may remember some of the lead information that we set up in Crmble. So it's automatically going to track the creation date. That's today, so I know when this contact was created. It was created here within Crmble. If I want to change that, I can do so. I can say, actually, you know what? We met at the conference here, so I'm going to choose other in this case, or I can go and create another source and actually label it conference. And in this case, I'm going to say that the value of this deal is about $1,500 because I want to track that information and be able to review that in my Crmble dashboard. In this case, I don't have to do anything else. I can just close this card as I would normally. And here you can see, as I selected in my Crmble interface, I've got Jane Doe. I've got that information on the front of the card. I can always go back and turn that off or adjust it as I like. But every time that I come back to this card, I'm going to have this information waiting for me. On top of that, Crmble makes it very easy for us to integrate with other Google products. So if I want to directly email Jane, for example, if I want to see her other contact information from my existing Google Contacts account, I can do so right here. So Crmble makes it really, really easy for us to access the information that we want. Here in the dashboard view, we're starting to see some information after we've entered in our first lead. But if we click on the leads option on the left-hand side of the menu, we can see the full details of the lead in which we just entered, but it also gives us the ability to both export and import our leads. So let's say that I already have a collection of leads with their contact information, and I'd like to start managing them here right within Trello. So I'm gonna select this option here, and then I'm gonna select the file which contains my existing leads. So here is my Excel file, and all I need to do at this stage is perhaps map a few of my fields. So for example, I can see that these are the lists or the headers in which I have within that Excel file. I just need to map them to my existing Crmble fields. So name is to name, surname, we've got phone number. Most of these are straightforward and you can double check them at any time. Of course, some of them, for example, my spreadsheet doesn't contain birthday information, so that's not going to be listed here in this particular case. I do have a source field, so I'm going to add that as well. When everything looks great, all I need to do is select continue, hit continue once again, and now I can double check and it looks like, yes, everything is in the format that I want. These are all the contacts I'd like to import into Crmble. Now that my import is complete, I have access to all of this information here right within Crmble and within my Trello board. In fact, if I select the contacts tab here on the left-hand side, I've got a nice clean way of viewing that information. So for example, if I want to find out more about Jesse Green, not only do I have his contact information here, but I can also see that he's been put into that new leads column, into that new leads list. Here back on my Trello board, I have access to all of that information here, and I can now start to funnel them through my specific workflow. So let's assume that I've been working with this Trello board for some time, and all those new leads that started out here on the left-hand side are now spread out amongst my various stages here within my sales funnel. Not only do I have their contact information available to me at a click, and remember, the name of the card does not need to be your client. You can name this anything that you want, but I always have their information nested here within their specific card, and I can keep track of their deal values as well. Here, when I go back to my Crmble dashboard, we've got some great information staring back at us. So I can see the total value of the deals available in my queue. I can see the percentages which have been followed up or closed or which are on a discovery call. I can even see all that source information here as well. And if I want to, I can filter by these categories as well. So I can see if things are moving the way I would assume, moving the way that I want to. But let's go back to our Trello board for just a moment, because the real power of Crmble is that you can repurpose these contacts contacts as well. So let's say someone like Jesse, for example, who I sold to in the past, is now up for a new deal. He's interested in purchasing something else from me. So I'm not going to call him a new lead. I'm going to say that we're going to reach out to him this week. So I'm going to say add a card. I'm going to say that this is a new big deal because maybe I've never had a returning customer at this point. I'm going to click on this card and I can add all of my regular Trello information that I want. But in this case, I'm not going to re-enter Jesse's information. I already have it in my CRM database. All I need to do is select add from my contacts, and I can either select from this list, but let's presume that I have many in this list. I'm going to search for Jesse. I'm going to select Jesse, and now bingo, it's attached right here to this card. This is a new deal, so I'm going to say that it is a walk-in. It's a returning walk-in customer. The creation date stays the same as of today, and this deal is maybe $5,700. I can now close it, and I've got all that information available to me, and I can continue to track the total value of this customer as well. And keep in mind, as long as you have Crmble installed on other Trello boards, you can access your same Crmble CRM database. So if you have a separate board for separate products or separate services, you can still access and use those clients across multiple boards. So if you want to turn your Trello boards into a fully functional CRM system, be sure to check out Crmble. Check out the link in the description below for more details. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.